In the last stream, we were working on setting up and automating these ultimate auto crafting tables to allow us to start crafting some of these very large late game crafts, and more specifically automating those late game crafts so that we can hopefully, at some point fairly soon, look at getting these infinity catalysts and then the infinity ingots and then crafting the infinity armor to complete the pack. We also, of course, set up these neutron collectors over here. And since the end of the last episode, I have crafted a few more of these. I've just requested that our system make them. And so far, it has done a fantastic job at making these. Now, since the end of the last episode, Ben, the pack maker, has pushed an update, making the end game a little bit easier and a little bit less grindy. So now, the neutron collectors here are faster. You'll see now it goes up by more than one percentage point per second, whereas in the last episode, it was like one percentage point every 2 seconds. And so I think the changelog said they now work about 3 times faster than they did previously, which is very nice indeed. And you'll see here that we now have 35 neutronium ingots. Ben also changed the recipe for neutronium ingots. So now it still takes 9 neutron piles to make 1 neutron ingot, but it no longer takes 9 neutron nuggets to make 1 neutron ingot. It's 4 neutron nuggets to make 1 neutronium ingot. And so it does require fewer nuggets. There is currently a bug or an exploit in the current version of the pack, because right now the storage drawer here still converts 1 neutronium ingot into 9 nuggets. And so you'll see at the top there, we're at 35 neutronium ingots. If I take one of these out, we go from 321 nuggets down to 312 nuggets. So it generates 9 nuggets when you put this in. And so in theory, what you could do if you wanted to exploit this is you could take 4 of these nuggets out, craft those 4 nuggets with an iron ingot, something like this, and then you could take that ingot, place it back into the drawer, and you get 9 nuggets. So you can basically turn 4 nuggets into 1 ingot, and that 1 ingot is worth 9 nuggets. So you can basically double the number of nuggets that you get at the cost of iron. I don't think we're going to have to abuse that exploit because these are now much faster. We can make these very easily. And I think for the most part, we should get enough neutronium ingots just via letting these work passively that we don't have to rely on that exploit, which I have been told is going to get patched out in the next version anyway. So now that that is taken care of, and now that we've completed the neutron collector questline, the big thing that we need to do now is we need to get a quantum compressor, and we need to look at automating the production of these infinity catalysts. Thankfully, you do now get 5 of these at a time as opposed to 1, and you do get 5 infinity ingots at a time as opposed to 1. And I believe some of these recipes have been tweaked as well to require fewer neutronium ingots than before. So the plan for today is going to be to get this quantum compressor, which I don't think is going to be too difficult. It requires a bunch of end steel, which we have. It requires a bunch of advanced and improved processes that we've already taught our system how to make. Same goes for the crystal matrix ingots. The only things we don't have are the 4 advanced air compressors, the 5 impulse hoppers, and then we do have the nuggets and the piles to make this quantum compressor happen. And I'm happy to report that in the new update, the quantum compressor is now capable of using a lot more power, which may sound like maybe not a good thing, but essentially, it used to be that the quantum compressor could only use 5,000 redstone flux per tick. Now it can use 100,000 redstone flux per tick, which essentially just means that we can make the singularities here faster. Because the 100 million redstone flux at the top there, that hasn't changed. It required that before. It used to be the case, though, that you had to get to that 100 million redstone flux at a rate of 5,000 redstone flux per tick, which takes over 16 minutes per singularity. That has now been tweaked. You can now pump up to 100,000 RF per tick into the quantum compressor, allowing you to make a singularity in under 60 seconds, which is good because we need quite a few singularities in order to make all of the infinity catalysts. The only problem is that currently we are not making anywhere near 100,000 redstone flux per tick. We are currently making 3,170-ish redstone flux per tick. And so the plan for today's stream is going to be to massively increase our reactor size here, to massively increase the amount of power that we're generating, hopefully to the point where we're generating over 100,000 redstone flux per tick, so that we can actually run the quantum compressor at max speed and get all of these singularities required in a reasonable period of time. Real quick though, let's start by requesting maybe 18 more of these double compressed crafting tables here. We're missing 512 stone for that, which is only the case because our storage drawer is actually limited by the fact that it's full. So one thing we should probably do is maybe grab a couple of upgrades for the draw. We do have 327 emeralds here, and so we can fairly easily make a couple of these tier 5 storage upgrades, which are the highest tier storage upgrade you can make, and I think it's probably worth putting these into a couple of the draws over here, specifically stone and deep slate. The deep slate is required to make a lot of the grains of infinity going forward, which are going to be required for some of the alloys that we need. As for everything else here, I don't really think that there's much more we need. I'm not quite sure why we ended up with netherite scrap here, of all things. I think I put a draw down to make this symmetrical and then just didn't lock it, which is why there's netherite scrap in there. But we'll put down a few more of these just to gather a few more of these resources. And we could do the same with endstone, but I don't really want to use all of our stone making more endstone. Instead, I'd rather use all of our stone to make those crafting tables. So back down here, how are those crafting tables doing? They're coming in. Once those are done, we can then make two more ultimate crafting tables. One of those ultimate crafting tables we still need to use to make the resource generator here, and the other crafting table I'm hopeful that we can use to craft this guy, the quantum compressor. And of course, we do need more ultimate crafting tables if we're going to automate the infinity catalyst and the infinity ingot as well. So let's quickly see if we can't make 4 advanced air compressors and 5 impulse hoppers. The advanced air compressors, I think, are by far and away going to be the easier part of this. For it, we just need more reinforced bricks. And speaking of reinforced bricks, I think what I'll also do real quick here is go ahead and throw quite a bit of iron over into this chest just to get us a lot of compressed iron to work with today. On top of that, if we're going to make our reactor bigger, we're going to need a lot of graphite. And the graphite is, of course, made by smelting graphite dust, which we get from powdered coal in the pressure chamber. So I think another thing that we should probably do sooner rather than later is maybe teach our system how to make the powdered coal, which I think it actually already knows, just not in the SAG mill, right? It's over here. It is indeed. Okay, in that case then, let's go ahead and I think request quite a lot of powdered coal. Give me like 512, start and start. We might need even more than that because we need a lot of graphite to build a really big, big reactor. And we have to run all this powdered coal through the pressure chamber here in order to turn it into the graphite dust. So we're going to want to run all of that through sooner rather than later. It shouldn't take too long because the pressure chamber is pretty full on pressure these days. But just to be safe, we should probably get that going earlier on. Back over here, though, we do now have what it takes to make more of these reinforced bricks. We can then craft up more of these regular air compressors. Once we have 4 of those, we then just need to get the advanced pressure tubes. Right now we have all we need, actually. Never mind. I didn't know if we had 4 of those or not, but it turns out we totally do. Fantastic. And so now it's just a case of making 5 of these impulse hoppers, which require copper alloy ingots and redstone alloy ingots. So if I'm not mistaken here, the copper alloy ingot is required as part of the singularity craft here. We need quite a lot of copper alloy ingots to make the copper alloy singularities. And so I do think it's going to be worth teaching our system how to make the copper alloy ingots here. It's in the alloy smelter with silicon and copper incurred. And we'll place that into one of our spare alloy smelters over here. As for the redstone alloy ingot, this is also not too difficult, actually. It's redstone and silicon. I will go ahead and teach this, although I don't think we need anywhere near as many of these alloys as we do the other ones. Real quick, I didn't do it in the last episode. I definitely should have done. Let's teach our system just how to make glass by smelting sand. We'll teach it in the alloy smelter, given that that's where we are going to do it. Also, we do need to kind of kickstart the system by getting some sand so that we can actually make the pattern to teach it how to make glass. But we should definitely do that just so that whenever we need something, we can just request it as opposed to having to go and manually put that sand in the future. Real quick, do we have what it takes to make more patterns now? We do. So we'll do one pattern for making glass, and we might even do one pattern for making patterns real quick here. If we do this and this, we can place that pattern into our spare crafting slot. We can place the glass smelting over into, let's put it in here. I think that's fine. And then down here, what we can probably do, do we have a spare exporter? We don't. We have a spare external storage, but we can probably make an exporter fairly easily. We can. We can request that our system make the processors for us there. And I believe we do have some cable lying around in our backpack. We do indeed. And so once we have those two pieces, the construction core and the improved processor, we can then take this, add it to our pattern grid like this, connect that up like so. And essentially now what we should be able to do is we should be able to request a pattern. Once that pattern's been made, we can then tell this to export patterns into here. And then if we get a crafting card, then much like before with the melon seeds, we can basically have our system continually craft more patterns and keep this pattern grid here full of patterns so that we don't have to keep crafting them manually. The crafting card is called the crafting upgrade, I believe, for refined storage. It is indeed. And for this, we just need another basic upgrade, which requires another one of those improved processes, as well as two more crafting grids and another construction call. Boom and boom. Nice. Let's throw that into here. And now we should just start to see, look at that, patterns arriving inside of the pattern grid. It is going to keep going until we have 64 there. And then once we do, it's going to stop crafting them until we use them. And I think that is perfect. So we were trying to make the red alloy ingot, this one right here. Let's go ahead and give that a quick encode. And we'll throw that, I think, into the same alloy smelter as this guy, the copper alloy ingot, just because, again, I don't think we need that many of these redstone alloy ingots. And then down here, with that taken care of, we are almost good to go. We do need 5 of these, so let's request 20 of the copper alloy ingots, start and start, and then let's also go ahead and request just 5 of the redstone alloy ingots. While we wait for those, let's get another hopper, let's also get another void chassis, and finally, let's go ahead and get 2 of these stone gears. And by 2, I of course mean 10, because we need 5 of these. And that is also true for the chassis. Do we have what it takes to make 1, 2, 3, 4 more? We do indeed. And of course, we need 1, 2, 3, 4 more hoppers. Perfect. Let's go ahead and see if we can't get all of those. We can. Fantastic. Do we have those double compressed crafting tables? We do indeed. Let's do something like this. And then let's straight to where request another 9 of those. Fantastic. So we can make another ultimate crafting table. And then in here, I think we should now be good to go. We do need to get a decent amount of end steel ingots to make this happen. This is 9, 18 plus, I believe, 16. So we need like 34. I'll request 40 here just to be on the safe side. And then what else do we need here? We need 2, 4, 6, 8 of each processor. That is completely fine. Let's request, I'm going to request 32 of each processor. And that's where we run into a string problem. And so string is going to be a problem on a few fronts. I did notice the reason I stopped making more neutron collectors was also due to the lack of string. Like if I wanted to request another batch of them here, the thing we're missing more than anything else is string. The other thing that we were missing was quartz enriched iron, but between streams I have gone ahead and tripled up on the quartz enriched iron chickens here. I gave another one 250 quartz enriched iron, and I just bred these two together to get the third one, and going forward, if we need more, we can breed more as well, because quartz enriched iron is really the big bottleneck for neutronium collectors. But string is also another bottleneck. So I do think it's probably worth getting a string chicken. The string chicken is easy enough to make. We just get 250 string and feed it to a chicken, which shouldn't be too difficult, but it is going to require that we do a fair bit of sapling growing and leaf shearing. Never mind, I have just been made aware of the fact that we can summon sheep using the summoning block and just a piece of wheat. That is very interesting. If we take our summoning block, and we place a single piece of dirt beneath it, which we don't have because I used all my dirt between episodes, because I've not mentioned it, but I did do a bit of base building between episodes, as you may or may not have noticed. I placed a roof, finally, onto the dome here. I also added a slightly different roof to the 3 semicircle platforms that we have next to our dome. And I've also added a couple of these lanterns as well around to make it just a little bit nicer. And we've used a lot of this pneumatic glass in the roof. And we've put down a lot of grass, which is a lot of dirt, which is just a lot of leaves. And I just did a lot of leaf farming between streams, growing a lot of saplings using the shears. Hence why we have so many of them lying around in our inventory. Now, that doesn't mean we don't have any dirt. Thankfully, we can get more leaves very quickly using our little sapling grower. Boom. And boom. We only need 1 dirt, which is just 8 leaves crafted like this. And then if we do something like this and like this, we should just be able to pump a staggering amount of wheat into that spawner to get a staggering amount of sheep. In theory, we have the ability to summon 3,049 sheep here if we wanted to. What I think we should probably do is get maybe like a netherite sword to allow us, oh, this has changed. They've changed the way you make netherite tools in the newest version of Minecraft. In that case, let's make a diamond sword. And over here, if we do something like this, people are telling me to shear the sheep. I don't know if it's, I guess we could shear them first, right, and then kill them, because I don't know if it's worth, I mean, I guess we could just kind of, we could have a lot of sheep just around, but I think we're going to cause a fair bit of server lag if we just leave a lot of sheep like this. So I think it's probably best if we kind of like shear them and then remove them so that we don't cause just a staggering amount of lag. I also think it's probably beneficial to turn off our jet boots temporarily, because that's going to make it easier for us to critically hit these sheep and kill them in one swoop. But the good news is that once we have all of the wool here, we can just run that through the squeezer again, like this, to get a bunch of string. I do still think it's worth getting the string chicken, though, because this is not really an automated process, and I would much rather have the string coming in automatically via the string chicken. And boom, just like that, we have a string chicken. Fantastic. Let's take you. He's 10, 10, 10. And let's plop him down for now and forever, I think, over in here. He's already got a drawer beneath him. That's fantastic. Is this ready to be configured? It is. I will rotate the drawer, of course, and we'll get this guy set to, ideally, string and feathers. All right, so this guy is fully set up. I am going to give him a quick 128x bump. We've still got 10 hours in our time in a bottle here. And hopefully that is going to get us a nice influx of string, ideally enough for us to go ahead and get this quantum compressor going. So for that, I wanted to get some more processors. Again, I would ideally like to get 32 of these requested and 32 of these requested, just so we have some left over for other crafts going forward. Speaking of which, I do think that it's going to be worth getting a couple of these speed upgrades. For that, we need some glass. Again, now, thankfully, we can request quite a bit of glass be made for us automatically, and then we can just kind of craft these as and when the glass comes in. 1, 2, 3, and ideally 1, 2, 3. Fantastic. I do believe there's already one speed upgrade in over here. We can throw the other three in. For now, that's fine. We will probably at some point look at replacing one of these with a stack upgrade, especially once we start doing the big late game crafts like the Infinity Catalyst, so that we're not waiting around for things to get imported. Either way, we have processors. Let's go ahead and grab those. We'll take all of them for now because they don't really take up much space. I guess 8 is what we needed on the advanced processor, which is coming in slowly but surely. While we wait for that, I think we're basically good to go. We do need 8 blocks of compressed iron. However, we did compress a bunch of iron right at the start of the episode. And in fact, we got 45 blocks worth of compressed iron here. So 8 is not going to be a problem. And I think that we are basically good to go. There's our 40 end steel. That is also done. Let's grab 8 neutron piles and 4 nuggets. 1, 2, 3, 4. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Perfect. Down here, we can almost make this happen. We are just waiting on these processors. We already have the impulse hoppers. That's fine. The advanced compressors we have. Are we good to go? Let me check here. I feel like we're missing something. We are. We're missing the 4 crystal matrix ingots. And look at that. We have exactly 4 of them. Fantastic. Boom and boom. Nice. All right. So now we are truly in the end game, because now we have to focus on making these infinity catalysts. So, as I mentioned before, the way the quantum compressor works, we place it down in here. We have the power on the left, and you can see it can hold 10 million FE. And as we said earlier, this does require 100,000 redstone flux per tick to run at its fastest speed. Other than that, we have 2 more slots here. Those slots are for the resource that we make the singularity out of. So for the energetic alloy singularity, we use energetic alloys. And the left slot, in this case, is for the quantum entangled singularity. This item isn't used. This just sits here and is required as like a catalyst to the main singularity craft. So these are not too bad. I say not too bad. However, they do require singularities. And the singularities are a little bit interesting, to say the least. So we do need quite a few of these singularities, because they are also required in the making of the infinity catalyst. You'll see we need 4 singularities per infinity catalyst. We did some number crunching. We need about 100. I think we need 88 infinity ingots, and we need, I think, 94 infinity catalysts to craft all of these armor pieces and the pickaxe in the middle there. So if we needed to get, let's say, 95 infinity catalysts to make it a nice number, that means we need to get 19 lots of all of these items, which means that we would need just shy of 80, 76, I think, singularities here. The singularities are made in the matter condenser. The matter condenser here, not too difficult to make. Let's quickly see if we can't make the matter condenser happen. I do believe we should still have a flux dust. Never mind. I always think we have flux dust, and we never do. We do still have some flux crystals, though. And if we place one of those into our inscriber, which is over here, let's do this one that's not doing anything. That should get us the dust. I'll turn all of that into dust for now. We can always make more flux crystals should we need them. That gets us a matter condenser. And then instantly, I am realizing that I am going to need some more flux crystals, I think, basically right away. So let's take all of our charged surface quartz with our nether quartz and our redstone. Boom, boom, boom. That's going to get us a bunch of flux crystals, hopefully enough to see us through to the end of the pack now. And the reason we need more flukes crystals here is that in order to make the singularity, there's two things we need. The first thing we need to do is we need to get ourselves a 64K ME storage component, which is a bit of a pain, but doesn't seem too bad. Let me do a little bit of crafting here. And speaking of crafting, I think I will require a few more crafters to make this happen. I'm going to quickly teach our system how to make the 64K crafting storage like this. And then we'll teach it also how to make the quartz glass like that. It already knows how to make glass, so that's fine. And then going down the pattern here to make the 64K storage, we do need three 16Ks. So we'll teach you how to make 16K. We then, of course, need the 4Ks. We'll teach you how to make 4K. And we need the 1K. We'll teach you how to make the 1K. And that requires Certus Quartz, which I guess we could also teach it how to make Certus Quartz and then also teach it how to make the silicon blend as well. I think that makes sense in this scenario. That is where the extra crafters come into play. We'll place one of those down right about here, and then we'll just dump all of these patterns in like so. And at that point, I think the only thing that it probably doesn't know how to make now is Certus Quartz dust, which we can just teach it like so, because we can then just tell it to put that over into this inscriber here. And I think at that point, our system might be able to make a 64K drive. It says it can. We'll hit start and we'll let that do its thing. I'm hopeful that that won't take too long. It did require a lot of redstone though. And essentially the way this works is we have to pump that 64K drive full of something. And that is where it turns out that we actually have access to some infinity disks. These guys right here, there's an infinity water cell, and there's also an infinity cobblestone cell. I don't know if it really matters necessarily which one of these we use. It is going to require a 16K component in and of itself to make, and so we should go ahead and request another 16K component here. And then whilst we wait for that, I think we're also going to need to get an ME drive, and we're also going to want to get, I think, an ME exporter. So we've kind of used refined storage for basically the entirety of our playthrough so far, but it looks like at the end here, we do need to do a little bit of applied energistics work in order to get the singularity. And I think the best way for us to get the singularity is going to be using the infinity disk, because you have to pump thousands of a given item, it doesn't matter what item, as long as it's an item, into the matter condenser to make that singularity. And as you've seen, we do need quite a few of them. And I do believe that's where those infinity disks are going to come in quite useful. So in here, the 64K component is done. Let me go ahead and request a 16K component. Actually, never mind, it's done. Perfect. Let's go ahead and we'll start with the cobblestone one. That does require a bucket of lava, but of course our system is now capable of making buckets of lava. And so hopefully that is easy enough. Fantastic. And then we just needed to get some more Certus Quartz dust. Let me get at least three of that so that we can make the ME drive here, because we need the quartz fiber, which is what the dust is for. There we go. The quartz fiber lets us make the ME cable, and the ME cable lets us make the ME drive cage. Perfect. The ME drive cage is where we can put the infinity disk. And so now this ME drive has a disk in it that has infinite cobblestone in. From there, we want to get an ME export bus, this one right here. This is the equivalent of an exporter from refined storage. And this is going to allow us to export the infinite cobblestone in this drive to the matter condenser. In the matter condenser, we want to swap this to condensed matter balls into singularities. It does require 256,000 items per singularity. But again, that's why we want infinite cobblestone. And so over here, let's do something like this to make the formation cores. And then we can do this to make an ME export bus, which we'll place in, on the matter condenser. We then want to grab one of those Fluix cables that we just made to connect that up like so. And then from there, I think there are two things we need to do. The first thing is that we need to give this power. And just like before, there are two options here. We could either use a controller to give it power, or we could use an energy acceptor, this guy right here, just like we did before with our melon setup. And I think the energy acceptor is probably going to be the easier of the two to make. It just requires some quartz glass. I assume the quartz glass is done. Fantastic. Let's place that down right about here. And then in my backpack, I do have an energy exporter along with an omnidirectional connector and some logic cable. And so we should be able to, once again, do this, do this, do this. And then if we grab a variable card, we can hopefully get power to this setup. We might see that come online. Look at that. Fantastic. That light is on. And so over here, we're going to tell this to export cobblestone. Let's do this and let's do this. And so now, look at that. It's exporting very, very, very slowly. And so now we need to get some upgrades. I do believe that we can put acceleration cards in here. I don't know what else we can put in. We can put in capacity cards, fuzzy cards, crafting cards, acceleration cards, and redstone cards. So I'm going to put in 4 acceleration cards, but I have a feeling that what we're probably going to want to do here is just craft up more exporters, because I think even with all of the acceleration cards, it's probably not going to be fast enough. Okay, so unfortunately, it looks like this energy acceptor is kind of not, like, the power's not being transferred fast enough. I don't believe that the controller is too difficult to make. It does require Skystone, which we don't currently have. We can trade with a villager to get Skystone at level 2. I think that's really our only option, because there's no Skystone chicken lying around. And so if we quickly grab another charger here, what we should be able to do is quickly spawn in another villager using our little summoner. And if we make him into a charging worker, we should hopefully be able to trade with him, because we have enough emeralds to make this happen. Is he going to convert? There we go. Okay, I did have to move a couple of items like this grindstone here, but we now have a novice flukes researcher, but he's disabled. We can't actually use him to do any crafting. Okay, fine. In that case then, I think that we might have to go find a meteor. There was a meteor down here where we spawned in initially, but the initial meteor that we found was right on a temple. And so maybe this one over here, if I go ahead and add waypoint and sky stone, question mark, we can maybe fly over there and see if there's any sky stone. And if there is, we could then hopefully just mine some and bring it back. All right, here we go. We can go ahead and grab a bunch of sky stone. Fantastic. And there's some surface in the middle there. I don't think we need it. Of course, our home stone should be in here. It is indeed. Let's use that to quickly pop back to our home base. And hopefully that is everything that we need to get our controller. Let's just quickly smelt 4 sky stone into the sky stone blocks required for the controller. And then in here, controller, can we craft this guy? We can. And the benefit of this is that it has a little bit of power that it can store inside of it. At the top there, 16,000 FE. And so that should keep this online basically all the time. And hopefully now we see this exporting more consistently. It's still not fast. And the Twitch chat has pointed out that there is an upgraded version of the ME export bus that we can make, called the ME extended export bus, which is just some acceleration cards and an improved processor. And this apparently is just faster by default. So if we do this, is there... Oh, there's so many more slots for acceleration cards here, which is fantastic. By default, apparently it is quicker, moving 8 items at a time instead of 1. But of course, we can still make yet more acceleration cards. Ideally, quite a few more acceleration cards to really try and fill up all of these slots. It looks like you can't put more than 5 in, or you can't put more than 4 in. So this is pretty quick, and we're almost at 256,000 for our first singularity. Although, I guess if we really wanted to here, we could probably just look at getting another exporter to make this even faster. Some people were suggesting the capacity cards, but the capacity cards won't actually do anything here. They just increase the number of slots inside of the ME export bus. And I'm very happy to see that the number of slots by default is much larger. It used to be that you could only put like a max of 9 filters into an export bus. Now it looks like the max is much, much higher than that. But what we definitely can do, though, is if we get more flux cable, we can just put down more exporters and utilize those exporters to export, you know, 2, 3, 4 times as fast, depending on how many extra exporters we place down. So if we do this and again set this to cobblestone, we can then drop in 5 more acceleration cards, and we should start to see this going much, much quicker, and we're going to start getting singularities. Now, in order to get the quantum entangled singularity, we need to blow up this singularity with the ender dust. So the ender dust here is made by just putting the ender pearl into the inscriber. That is completely fine. I don't think we're going to need that many of these, so I don't think it's worth teaching the system how to do it. We can just take the dust here, and then you just have to blow these up, but there is a very specific little TNT here that you can use to blow it up. You can use any TNT, but this tiny TNT here is added by Applied Energistics because it makes a very teeny tiny little explosion, just big enough for us to ideally get the quantum entangled singularity. So if we go ahead and drop down somewhere in the desert, let's say over here, if we drop down our singularity along with our ender dust, and then we put down the tiny TNT, and we blow this up, I believe we should get 2 quantum entangled singularities. Nice. And these are the catalysts required inside of the quantum compressor. If I press U on this, you'll see it's only used for us here is to make these singularities. But again, we would want ideally 100,000 redstone flux per tick being generated here in order to make these singularities as fast as possible. And so I think at this point in time, we kind of want to pivot our goals over to making our reactor bigger. One thing I will do real quick is I will get another storage drawer and I'll place that down just as soon as we texture it to store all of the singularities that we're getting, because we do want to keep getting more singularities so that we hopefully will have enough when the time comes to do the final crafts. So if I do this and I do this, I don't know exactly how many we're going to need. It might not be more than 64, but on the off chance it is more than 64, we can go and do something like this. And this doesn't really cost us anything other than a little bit of power to keep this whole thing running, because of course this disk is infinite. So we're just pumping infinite cobblestone into here and producing an infinite number of singularities. So in terms of making more power with the reactor, we need to make a bigger reactor, which we kind of talked about before, because we have used exclusively just basic reactor casing, which is only able to make a reactor up to 5x5x5. So this is the biggest reactor that we can make with this basic casing. If we want to make a bigger reactor, we need reinforced casing, this stuff right here, which is regular casing with 4 more graphite and 4 more iron. So just basically the same recipe again, but with the basic casing in the middle. And we can then use that to make a much bigger reactor, which is capable of producing a lot more power. And ideally, we want to get around 100,000 redstone flux. And so I think we want to build a much larger reactor, maybe something like a 13x13x13 reactor. Now, to do that, we just need a lot of iron and a lot of graphite. So we do have 7 graphite in here. We did request a bunch of the coal earlier. Yeah, we got a ton of powdered coal in here. So we can, of course, go ahead and take all that out and dump it in over here. But I don't think that's going to be enough. If we want to make a 13x13x13 reactor, we're going to need around 1,000 reactor casing. And if we want to get 1,000 of this reactor casing, that means that we need, basically, we just multiply it by 8. And that's the amount of iron and graphite we need. So I think we need about 8,000 graphite and about 8,000 iron as well, which is absolute madness. And so right now, how are we doing on iron? We've got 3,000 iron and we've got like 1,000 coal. So the answer really is not enough of either of those. And so I think that what we're probably going to want to do here, chat, is just go crazy with the chickens. I think we need more coal chickens. I think we need more iron chickens. I think we can probably go ahead and teach our system here how to make the reactor casing, the reinforced variant, and how to make the regular basic casing, like so. And we'll put both of those in to our crafters up here. And that should be fine. One other thing I think we should definitely do is teach our system how to smelt the graphite dust. That's not going to be a problem. We'll stick that into one of our alloy smelters. Let's do, I don't think it really matters which one we do here because we're not going to overlap with any of these, but we'll put it in the one with netherite because we're not making any netherite at the moment. And then the trickier part is teaching our system how to make the actual graphite dust. I say trickier, it's not really that tricky. It should just be a case, I think, of teaching it this recipe here. Encode, we can then take one of our crafters we crafted earlier, place that over here, ideally just onto this chest. Not quite like that, of course. We want to make sure it points in like this. Place this guy down like so. And then if we can get enough refined storage cabling, we should then hopefully be able to use our pipe layer to run from a pre-existing pipe over to there. Now, where is our nearest pre-existing pipe is a good question. There is pipe here. We do have to be careful not to break the trim. Let's say that we go from here, of course, with this in our offhand, from here over to here. That's gonna run like this. If you shift right click in the air, you can change the default pathfinding to A star pathfinding. It says this will find the shortest path between two points and it will try and go around ores. And I think I was told it also goes around pipes now as well. So let's go ahead and kind of shift scroll that down a bit like this. Let's go down one more. Wait, I can't go one more. This is as low as it'll go. Wait, that's 99. Oh, I see. We need to go to a depth of 7 before it actually goes deeper. I see the depth is on like the receiving end. Fair enough. Let's do it there. Shift right click, place pipes. We are going to have to cover this, but I think that should bring that online. It totally does. And of course, we'll want to get a cover there as well. But ideally, our system should now know how to make the graphite. And so in theory now, if I was to go ahead and, you know, try to request, let's say, 1,000 of the reinforced reactor casing, it knows how to make it. We just need a lot more coal and a lot more iron. And so real quick, what I'm going to do, I'm going to take 250 coal. I'm going to feed it to one of our 10-10-10 chickens. We only have two left, so I'm going to breed another 10-10-10 chicken real quick. Let's do this and this. Once those guys are bred, I'll take one of the pre-existing chickens and we'll use that to make another 10-10-10 coal chicken. From there, what we'll do is we'll just breed together the two 10-10-10 coal chickens that we have to get more coal chickens, and we'll also breed together more iron chickens to get more 10-10-10 iron chickens. We'll throw all those guys down, and we'll hopefully really start to ramp up our coal and iron production. And then, depending on how our melons stack up, we might also look at adding more melons to the equation as well. And then, hopefully, once we have enough coal and enough iron... Speaking of iron, by the way, we do have 4,000 iron over here, raw iron, that just needs to be smelted. So we could also look at throwing down some blast furnaces and smelting some of that up to get the iron somewhat more quickly. So it's really just the coal that we're limited on. There are a few recipes. For example, we could use some of our fuel. Also, I do forget about the fact that the extractinator works here. I think that's not going to be particularly fast, because although we could use a clay chicken to get terracotta, I feel like at that point we might as well just get a coal chicken. You can also use the fluid mixer to make coal, but I don't think it's going to be fast enough. I think we're going to want to get just a bunch of chickens down and really start to pump out the coal that way. Okay, so I know I said that I wasn't going to use the fluid mixer here, but I think I might use the fluid mixer here, because it turns out that we have got a lot of fluid and it doesn't actually use that much to make coal using this. It takes 50 millibuckets of gasoline and kerosene, for example, to make 3 coal. And so if we take this tank and this tank from here, and we go and put both of those into our fluid mixer over here, boom and boom, it pretty quickly makes the coal. And of course, we can put in speed upgrades. No, we can't put in speed upgrades. Interesting. But we can maybe time and bottle it to make it a lot faster. And then if we get an importer with like a stack upgrade on it and maybe some speed upgrades, I think we could make this real fast at producing coal. We already have the importer. The speed upgrades are not too difficult. Let's go ahead and get quite a few of these. I'm going to request more processors because we're basically out of those. Give me another 30. What a slime. Slime is not something we have automated, and we should definitely look at teaching our system how to make that using the strainers. For now, though, let's do 1, 2, 3, 4. That there is enough for a stack upgrade. Ideally, I do think we want maybe the stack upgrade with a couple of speed upgrades. If we put both of those onto here, which we might be able to do like this, and like this, with this and this, that should pull in the resultant coal. And then from there, we can probably just do this. I mean, we could also do this and this. I think both of those are fine with fluid pipes to move the items over, which I think would be more sensible as opposed to us trying to do it manually. And at the same time, I do think it's probably also worth... Oh, do we have any more plastic? We do. Okay, cool. I was going to say it's probably also worth trying to get 2 more tanks to replace the tanks that we just broke so we can make some more of the gasoline and kerosene kind of passively in the background. We are out of plastic now. That's unfortunate. But let's do this and this just to kind of keep producing those while we work on other stuff. Let's also get more of these fluid pipes. Good stuff. And I think we'll also want to get some pipe upgrades here to make this substantially faster than it is by default. Let's do 2 of these improved pipe upgrades. Let's go boom, boom, and then using our wrench, we can go boom, and make sure we disconnect this with a boom here, and then a boom, and a boom, and hopefully that's going to keep pumping those in. And then from there, I'm hopeful that we can kind of do something like this and make it a good deal faster, and just kind of keep going and just producing a staggering amount of coal. How much coal are we acquiring here? It's going up pretty quickly. Look at that. We needed like 6,000, and we're getting like 100 every second, every couple of seconds. It's coming in real quick. And so if we did want to get 1,000 reactor casing, what was the number we needed? We need 3,400 more coal. I don't know if we'll quite get there with the kerosene and the gasoline that we have because we are now fully out, but we can do the same thing with the other two fluids as well. If we go and put these back, then we can do the same thing again with diesel and with LPG. That's going to get us not quite as much, because I think you only get two at a time here instead of three. I also do wonder if I break this and replace it, does it empty out its internal buffer? It doesn't, but I can kind of shift it to the output slot there, which is awkward. I don't know if there's a way to like actively get rid of... Actually, I guess I can just go put these back in these tanks, right? I can just do this and this, and that's completely fine. Perfect. So over here, let's do the same thing again with our other fluids. Let's set both of those to extract here and here. Let's once again throw in the pipe upgrades. We'll do that here and here. That's going to start producing more coal. I think two at a time this time instead of three at a time. But again, we still do have 10 hours in our time in a bottle. And so if we just give that a very rapid bit of acceleration, we should tear through the liquid and we should get a bunch more. Cool. Nice. And then we can kind of do a similar thing, I guess, with the blast brick furnace here. If we take this blast brick furnace and we take the 4,000 raw iron that we have here, we can kind of move this importer once it's done over here onto the blast brick furnace. And again, just use the time in a bottle to rapidly accelerate our way through that 4,000 iron until hopefully we have enough iron to make this happen. So how are we doing here? We're still missing 1,500 coal. How are you doing over here? This thing's still going. Let me give it another tap to really tear through the remaining LPG and the remaining diesel. Is this a more efficient craft or is this just the same but worse? It is the same but worse because you get two instead of three, but that's completely fine. We are still getting a staggering amount of coal that we apparently just had backlogged in our fuels. I kind of wish I'd have made bigger tanks maybe because we've been leaving those passively for a while now. So that might be pretty close. How are we doing? We need 900 more coal. That is completely fine. I think that's the last of the fuels here. Not quite. But even if that is the last, we can always give our chicken a bit of a tap to try and squeeze out the last of the coal if we really need to. And yeah, I'll basically do the same thing here. I'm going to take the import bus with the stack and speed upgrades. I'm going to put them onto the blast brick furnace here. And we're just going to feed in the raw iron, extract out the cooked iron, and that's going to give us a bump of like 4,000 iron. Okay, so I've set up a horrible contraption here, and don't worry, this fall hazard is temporary. But over here, this does work, and we have started burning through the iron here. And if I give it a tap all the way up to 128, it does start going very quickly. However, it does take half an hour out of my time in a bottle, and as you can see, I've already done that quite a few times. And so I think we kind of just need to do more chicken work. Now, I think we can make our chicken setup like more simple or simpler, I should say, to expand. So if I were to go ahead and get some more item conduits, I am fairly certain that also let's just request some more pulsating iron here so that we can get more conduits made. I'm fairly certain that the chickens produce their resources and then the resources sit in the nests. And so right now we have them pumping that into the drawers beneath them. But I think we can just do this where we place the stasis chamber, aka the nest, directly onto the pipe. And then if we set the pipe to insert and extract, so basically in here, we're going to say insert and extract. We have both those ticked. We're going to insert for the seeds. So you'll see this has seeds in it. And then we're going to extract. We're going to extract on a different channel. Let's say we extract on the brown channel. The reason for that is that we're going to go always active, and then we're going to run our item conduit down and around to our pre-existing chest, the one that actually imports all of the items. So if we dig over here, our chest is right there. I do need to put the item back down. I probably decided to extract again. But if we do this and we say that this should insert on the brown channel like that, what we then should be able to do is replace this down, of course, like so, and make sure that's all connected. It is, and also make sure it's set to extract. But then if we go around this way, I am fairly certain that we should be able to connect this up like so. And now any resources made by any chicken in this nest should hopefully just go directly to the chest without having to go through the intermediary drawer, because the drawers, they're not difficult to make, but they do kind of slow us down in terms of how fast we can expand out our chicken army. So if I put this here now and I were to accelerate this, I think we should see, yeah, like the iron goes into the stasis chamber and then gets pulled out. That's fine. And the benefit now, though, is that we can just keep breeding these iron chickens because they breed so quickly. So if we were to go ahead and take two seeds here, we can just go and breed these two guys. That's going to get us a baby iron chicken, which of course we can grow up very quickly. And then once he's grown, these guys only take 24 seconds to cool down. And so while we wait, we can go ahead and grab you, move you over to here, make sure this is set to insert on green and then to extract on brown and always active. And that's as long as it takes us to duplicate our chicken setup now for iron. And so I think we're going to put down a bunch of iron and a bunch of coal chickens, because although we're somewhat close on being able to make the 1000 reactor casing, don't forget that once we have that, we still need to fill the reactor with fuel rods. And so we do need a ton of iron and a ton of coal, because the fuel rods alone here also require a bunch of iron and a bunch of graphite. And for some reason, the reinforced control rods here require blocks of iron, not just iron ingots. So we need lots of iron.